So, yes, as Jen said, I'm going to be doing a fashion illustration and drawing workshop. Just a quick introduction. I'm a London-based artist, and I mostly work within fashion illustration and print design, which means I get to do lots of prints for garments. For example, things like this. I would have worked with a fashion company called eBlues, and I would have done some artwork for them, and they would have started to create a collection out of it. So that's one part of my job that I do. I also sometimes get commissioned by magazines to cover fashion, catwalk shows, and to draw specific events. And I've got an example of this right here. So this is from some time ago, but I just wanted to show you the differences of the kind of jobs that I might get commissioned to do. Alongside that, sometimes I've done a few homeware projects where I've designed patterns to go on duvet covers. I've designed shop windows. And sometimes I go to events and draw live there. So it's precarious, I think, to be a freelancer, but also it's lots of fun. It just means that you're always getting new experiences. And also there's quite a lot of artwork in the background as well. That's mostly me. Before we begin the workshop, I'm just gonna show you some of the equipment that I use. And here we go. These are some of my favorites. Hopefully you can see these. They're by Stabilo, and the name is Woody, Stabilo Woodies. But I literally love these. These are my absolute favorite thing. And if you want to treat yourself to any kind of art equipment, I would definitely, I'm not being sponsored by them, I just love them. What's really nice is you can see like how solid they are. It's like they're really sturdy. And I press like really, really hard when drawing, so it's very useful. I've got a handful of pens. I don't use lots and lots of pens, but they're good to have as a highlighter. And also one of the exercises we're gonna do, you do need a pen. But you can see I've got a variety, like big marker pen here. Actually, these are even bigger. I've got some really nice, big, chunky pens as well. And then ranging all the way down to a biro. So yeah, I think I've got more, there's more time. But I think when you're creating, you know, if you're gathering art materials, I think it's always just good just to like trial and error. Like, you know, I might say, oh, I love these crayons. You might try them and think, oh, they're terrible. So yeah, it's always good to explore. I've also got lots of different paint. I've only got a few with me today, but again, I really work with I use lots of different kinds of brands. I'm not loyal to anything there, but I do love to have some paint and just love the immediacy of it. And, you know, like going into an art store, just like looking at all the colors, I go in for one color and then I come out with five or 10. And then finally, this is like my favorite. These are like my bottle. Well, I think it's my favorite. But these are, I don't know if you can see that well. It looks nicer in real life. I mean, they're very grubby. These are oil pastels, oil crayons that I would have got. And it's a brand called Caran d'Ache. But again, you can see they're just broken into little pieces. Because they press so hard and then they just break. But I do quite like it when an oil pastel or a crayon goes quite small, because then you can use it on the side, which I'll demonstrate later. But I literally keep things till the bitter end. This is like the size of my nail practically. And sometimes I'm gonna say again this here. I did a job at Christmas. I was having to color in leaves for a Christmas tree and had to use this color. I was like, this, you know, started, so I had to finish. And literally we got down to just the tiniest, it was a speck. I was like putting it on with my finger. So yeah, never throw it away until it disappears. And then of course, obviously we've got some paper, that's pretty important. I've got some A3. I often work on, let's do that now. often work on A2 paper. I do think that's really nice, just but because of kind of time and also, you know, like the restriction of the camera, I'm keeping at this scale. But, you know, if you've got bigger, feel free to use, or if you revisit this workshop, you know, try different scales of paper. I think that's really important to change things up a little bit. And then some of you, or lots of you, might have downloaded the info pack that hospital rooms have put together. And I've included like a handful of fashion images, and also some of my patterns as well that we're going to draw from. If for those of you who didn't manage to download the images, while we're doing the warm-ups, like feel free to perhaps go and grab a book or a fashion magazine, or find an image online, or I'll try and keep my image in view so you can see it, so you can draw from here. But yeah, feel free to go and get your own images if you haven't downloaded this. Or obviously, if you've got someone in your house that wants to remodel, that's also a great alternative. So I guess let us begin. Didn't properly explain what we're going to be doing. Basically, we're going to be drawing. I'm going to be giving you some techniques and some exercises that I hope are going to encourage your like freedom of expression. That's the first thing. But also, I hope that you'll be able to use them in the future as fashion design tools. Especially the main exercise that we're going to be doing, and I'll talk about it when we're doing it, but you might be able to design your own clothes or prints onto there. Again, you can be doing that with me, or you can do that, a different version of it in your own time. So to start off with, I always warm up. And you know, when I'm in my studio, I don't necessarily like set myself tasks, but what I do is I don't set myself any expectations with the first even hour, sometimes day, that's generous, but maybe half a day. Like if I get anything good, great. But the idea is, or the thinking is, there's every chance that I won't get anything great. Warming up is really, really important. And to begin with, what we're gonna do, the way we're gonna warm up really is speed. We're going to draw quite fast, and it's gonna get even faster, okay? So I've picked this image, but really you're free to use whichever one you fancy. And again, like I said, if you've got someone who's modeling for you, even better. Pick an image. If you want to do this one with me, that's fine. If you want to do your own, that's also fine. And basically there's no instructions on this warm-up. It's really also to have something down so that you can maybe see if you've developed, or you're like, oh, that was the first drawing. It's the first time I've ever drawn a person before. Like maybe that's quite nice to have, you know, keep in your arts archive. And also for people that are like, oh, I'm a bit scared to get drawing straight away. Also in the pack, there was some templates. So feel free to draw clothes onto the templates if that's gonna make getting started easier. So the only real instruction is for this is to fill the page. So make sure that you start with the figure at the top, with the head at the top, and then fill the whole page so it goes right the way down to the bottom. So we don't have like teeny tiny drawings. Don't worry what it looks like. Just worry about getting everything down, because we're only going to have 3.5 minutes. Okay. Jen, are you able to give us a timer, please?
Yep, I'm about to start this timer, Helen. And
all right.
Start in 3, 2, 1, and you get 3 minutes now.
All right, here we go, guys. Now, so I'm already like, I don't know which equipment to start with, but I suggest less thinking and just, oh God, the camera shakes when I scribble, sorry about the shaking camera. And what I like to do, like I said, it's just like, just go for it. Like just get some lines down, because sometimes, especially the longer we have, sometimes people take about 3 minutes just to decide which color to use, or maybe they start with some very light pencil marks and then they realize that you can't even see it and they have to go over it again. Yeah, the key is to get started. You'll notice that I'm doing a lot of marks. So this is, I describe this as a scribble. And again, this is in your information pack. Sorry about the shaky camera. This is what I mean though about me pressing very hard and I'm moving my image up a little bit. For me, drawing is really, really physical. And we're gonna talk about that in the next exercise. But yeah, be present on your page. That's what I always think. And yeah, this is a nice opportunity when we're just doing a warm-up, just to explore some of your equipment as well. Some of you might be using some equipment that, oh God, you know what? I'm looking at the image on the screen where I've got it right next to me. That's weird, sorry, I'm just having some weird visuals. Can't remember what I said, but yeah, it's maybe a nice way to explore some of your new equipment. With the image that I've picked, sorry if I'm talking a lot, I warned you about this, Jen, didn't I, that I often can't stop talking. But with the image that I've picked, there's lots and lots of pattern on there. Not so much texture, but there's definitely pattern. So if you feel a bit nervous of the figure, because that always used to help hold me back, like trying to get the figure right, just like I've done really, just focus on those patterns. Well, they're saying that, I think I might just add a little bit of line to it. Well, Jen, what's our time? How are we doing on time?
We've got 30 seconds left.
Oh no, what? Oh my goodness, okay. Right, okay guys, and so that's when suddenly we're like, oh my goodness, I've got to move really fast. And I love this like continual line, which we're gonna look at later, but just using a frantic line to try and get everything in. You can really, you know, I was really taking my time a little bit too much. Always get a face. I've left the face till the last minute, which normally
Just hit 3 minutes, Helen.
Hit 3 minutes. All right, I'm gonna give us all 30 more seconds. And I've just put a little face in there. Not sure the model would be very impressed with the face they've given her, but that's okay. So I'm done. I'm gonna hold up my drawing so you can see it in there. And again, I said to you guys, it does not matter what this drawing looks like. I actually really like mine. And what I enjoy, so it's very hot in my house, I'm like melting, or maybe I've been turning the fan on. What I enjoy about this is the variety of different speeds, because you suddenly saw how much faster I had to go with that black line, because Jen was like, oh, you're nearly, it's times near the art. So you're always having, when you're drawing, you're always having to like change things up, because maybe the time's running out, or maybe you've got a new texture that really is going to require you to do some movement. So yeah, drawing isn't just sat there like sketching, like you can see my face where I'm just like leaning my head in the hand, like just being very gentle and taking your time. For me, drawing is like energy and heat. I'm just turning on my fan, hopefully you can't hear that. Okay guys, so that was your first drawing. And I know for some of you, you might think, oh no, it's awful. Two, you might have thought it was way, way too fast. But like I said, that's fine. But with fashion design, and also just when you're working, I think in the industry, there's not always a lot of time. So that's why I always introduce these like speedy exercises. But also, some of you might have noticed, I'm just getting ready for the next exercise. Some of you might have noticed that because it was so fast, you didn't have time to think or hesitate or like, oh, it's hand in the right place. You saw me in that frantic moment. I didn't care whether the foot was in the right place. I just cared that it was down there, okay? And you might think, oh, it's kind of a bit weird to tell me not to think, but I find from my own experience and from other teaching, you know, other students that I have taught, that sometimes thinking is what holds us back. is what stops you having kind of like an intuitive drawing. I'm looking for not a drawing that looks perfect, or not a drawing that is exactly like what you're looking at. I'm looking for a drawing that shows how you think and how you naturally express yourself. Right, okay, so moving on, fast-paced workshop, and you know, watch it back again as well if you're like, oh, I want a little more time. I'll allow that. So what's going to happen next is that we're going to do some super, super fast drawings. Okay, so they're going to be, sorry as well, I didn't paint my nails, I meant to do that. Apologies. We're going to do 30 second drawings. Okay, and we're going to do, let me just count how many images I've cut out. We're going to do four, maybe five. Let's do five. And again, I'll show you the images I'm going to use. I'm going to be using this one. I'm going to be using this one. I think most of the catwalk images that you have got. There we go. So most of those images that you've got on a printed sheet, like you can see actually they're all here as well. And again, it's not really important which ones you use, but I'll make sure after each exercise I tell you which one I'm going to use next. Let's start with this one. And again, there's no real instructions. I can give you top tips, but the main thing is about the speed and about the way we're putting it down. Again, fill the page, that's always great. I'm gonna start off with using some oil pastels, and I'm gonna use them on their side, I think, so I can just get some really quick coverage. But I think I might then also start to use some line as well. Let's just see, like often this page is chaotic, like frenetic, it's full of speed and energy. So yeah, let's see what we can get. And what's gonna happen is each drawing will be 30 seconds. Don't worry about, especially with this one, don't worry about all the stripes and the details. We're trying to get the shape down. And if you get any chance to put a detail down, that's great. But the main thing is to just get us moving. So Jen, may we have a timer, please? They're gonna be 30 seconds. And yeah, so just keep resetting the time. And if you could tell us when there's like 10 seconds left.
Yes, no problem, Helen. We have 30 seconds starting now.
Ah, okay. Okay, I'm going to put my image so you can see it. All right, okay, so I've got started. And like I said, I'm just using the side of the pastel here. And you can't see, well, you can tell by the shaking of the camera that I am moving. I'm not sat slumped. That's like my pet hate when I see people like—
10 seconds left, Helen.
Okay, I'm gonna get the legs in. Let's have a different color for the legs. And she's got no arms, but does that matter? Yeah, she's got the arms. Okay, I'm done.
Time's up.
Yay! Okay, so this is my first one. Okay, there we go. Oh, sorry, I can just hold it there. I thought you can see it. So I'm gonna get rid of that one. I'm gonna move on to this one next. Again, remember the point of this is to be physical and to warm up. So do not worry if your drawings aren't looking gorgeous. I'm gonna use an oil pastel again, but I think I'm gonna use it as a line this time. Again, your choice. Some of you might wanna do paint. That's also really nice. So Jen, maybe have 30 seconds.
Sorry.
Guys, they're all on the same page. If you really like this, because I quite like this image, I'm surprising myself. And you know what, guys, it's okay to say you like your own drawing. Some people are so like, oh, hate my work, but I like this. If you like the drawing, photograph it before you draw the next image on top of it, okay? So, 30 seconds. This is my next drawing. This is the next person I'm drawing. And we're gonna start. Oh, Jen, you're up to you.
We're gonna start now.
Okay, amazing. So like I said, what I'm gonna do is mostly a line, but what I'm really aiming for is to get an outline and just to kind of bring some movement to the page. Often when I do these, I get the model to stand in a really exaggerated pose.
So, 10 seconds, Helen.
So if you're doing this at home and you have a friend modeling, maybe you can get them to stand in really weird shapes.
That's 30 seconds up.
Thank you, because then it makes you kind of move a bit more. All right, this is going to be my next one. So you can see I'm kind of building up. You still feel like people, but you can see it's going to start to be a little bit chaotic, isn't it? This is my next image that I'm going to draw. I might use a variety of, that might ruin it, mightn't it? I'm going to start off with this big, thick pen. Let's see what I end up doing with it. But like I said, this is a nice opportunity in the warm-ups to explore your materials. All right, Jen, when you're ready.
Okay, you've got 30 seconds starting now.
Okay, and again, guys, like drawing on top of your images, like on top of work that you've already done, it just stops you being precious, you know, because you're like, don't like that. I don't like what I've just done. But it doesn't matter that I don't really like what I've just done, because I know that I'm about to cover it up with
5 seconds left, Helen.
5 seconds. I might just get a diamond in. There we go. All right. Okay, I'm done. Is that up to Jen? Is that Jen? Jen?
Thumbs up, perfect.
Is that amazing? Okay, so, you know, I'm still into my page, and what I would suggest, if you like, each time you add a new layer, maybe you like what's happening. So, you know, maybe take a photograph of it if you have like a camera nearby. If you don't, it's not necessary at all. It's just about creating some joy on the page, which really is like one of my whole purposes, I think, when I'm drawing, just to be a little joyful. So we've got two more drawings left. This is the next one I'm going to do. Some of you might think, oh, do you know what? I'm going to turn the page upside down. And well, I'm not going to, I don't think. But you might just want a new starting point, and it makes you ignore what's underneath. That could be an option as well. I'm going to stick with it this way, but it's always good to challenge yourself and make changes. So I'm going to do, I think I'm going to do the shading again this time. And yeah, Jen, so when you're ready, 30 seconds.
We've got 30 seconds starting now.
Oh, I nearly cheated then. I nearly started a little bit earlier. And again, the one that I've got now, the image that I'm drawing from now, she stood at a slightly different angle, which is just nice to have on the page. And I don't know if you can see me. Maybe you can see me. I'm like really trying to physically move as well. I'm done. She is done. And notice that I'm not putting any detail. For me, what the interest was there was the pose. So I really tried to like push that. And we got our final one now. This is the one that I'm going to finish with. And I think I'm going to put a black line, I think. Or I think definitely I'm going to put something vaguely linear. And with this final one, because it's the final image that you're working with, like have a little thing, how do you want to end this? Like I'm now trying to decide which color. And the way I decide my colors, like I don't just be like, oh, that will do. I've got a blue here and I hold that next to the screen. I mean, next to my drawing. It's like, is that the color? Or actually, maybe the green is gonna be better. So it really allows you to make some decisions. But anyway, yeah, let's go. Let's get this finale.
Okay, we've got 30 seconds starting now.
Okay, right. And again, now you've had like a little bit of experience with this speedy drawing. You know, maybe you're gonna pick your favorite technique, which actually is what I'm doing. I realized my favorite technique is when the pastel is on the flat.
10 seconds, Helen.
Okay. All right. I didn't make much of an impact with that. That's fine though. I notice that even though there's still time, I'm saying I'm done. Done with that now. It's done.
And just to let everyone know that we're about halfway through the workshop today.
Okay.
And Helen, we've got some questions and some helps to do as well.
So amazing.
A big hello to everyone joining us from Ashfield Ward at Parkview Clinic. Hello. Hi to Ellis and everyone at Oakwood Ward. They really have been looking forward to today's session.
Yay.
We've got a big hello from Aline in Italy, who says that was amazing work. And a question, Helen, from Leno, who says, they most struggle to draw hands, feet and faces. Have you got any tips or good exercises to work on these?
Oh, good. Okay. I mean, so first of all, like what I'm always told is, one of my tutors told me just, I'd leave the hands out. And he's like, you're never going to improve unless you keep drawing, like unless you actually try to draw them. So that's the first thing, like actually just keep approaching them, but also don't see them as any different to the way you draw the rest of the figure. And I'm gonna do a continual line exercise next. And that's always my answer to everything that I'm having trouble with. And so I would approach them with a continual line, but also you just saw my drawing, like look at the fudge. I'm holding it up, I'll put it here. Look at my weird fudge and look at my weird hand and look at my weird face. So I'm not well versed in hand, feet or faces either. And in fact, I don't really have any technical, I did a degree in art and print design, etc., but I didn't get taught anything technically. So I kind of embrace things that don't quite work. So maybe, you know, embrace when you say you can't, I mean, of course you can draw the hand. It is just like drawing any other body part, any other detail, but also why not spend an hour, like every day, like 10 minutes on the hands, 10 minutes on the feet, 10 minutes on the faces. Face is really good with continual line, which I'm going to show you. Sit in the mirror. Do some portraits, draw your face without looking, draw everything without looking. So then you're focusing on what you're looking at rather than what you're drawing. That's actually what I meant to say, because you're clearly maybe overthinking and worrying too much. So everything becomes about that hand, basically. Does that help? I hope that helps. Sorry, I just am aware of the time, but we'll, I can't really see any. I can see the feet on here. But I'll talk about the continual line and how that might help you with the hands as we do the next exercise. Okay. And just finally, with this drawing here, some of you might love what you've got. Others of you might think, oh, it's rubbish. But maybe you're going to tear it up and make a collage out of it. There's always something in your own time. There's always something to do with a piece of artwork, even if it isn't what you'd actually intended it. But yeah, if you're interested in print design, you can see how this could be a lovely start to a print. Right, I better move on. Told you I can't stop talking. So our next drawing, it's gonna be a little bit longer and it might be what takes us to the end of the session, but I'm going to talk about the continual line. So I might start drawing as I'm talking, just to get us moving. But what's going to happen, and you know, draw along with me. I'm going to use this image, but again, choose any of the ones that you've got. All of them really work. But what we're going to do is we're going to get a pen, but this time this is important that you use a pen. Any kind of pen will work. Something like this, not so much though. That's a little bit too thick, unless you're on a really big piece of paper, but I'm just gonna use this, it's not fine, it's kind of a brush. It's got a slight brush pen to it. Now start at the top, okay? And what we're gonna do is we're gonna keep our pen on the page at all times. And some of you might have done this and you might be like, oh, I know what we're doing. But for me, this is just everything. This is how I start all my work. Now, I might go a little bit faster, just you know, for time, but feel free to take your own time, because there's a few things that I want to talk about as we're drawing. The main reason that I do this continual line is so I can connect with the figure or with my subject, you know, because you could do this if you're drawing a vase of flowers, if you're drawing a plant pot, landscape, whatever you might be drawing. And it just really makes you understand your subject. Now, as you're drawing, I really feel as though I'm touching the outside of the image. So I'm really, really that attached to it. I start to notice details. So I start to notice, I loved, you can notice I've really exaggerated her shoulder. You can't see that well, but here, she's got like quite a rounded shoulder, and I really liked that. So I enlarged that a little bit. And so it just means that you're very much aware of all the details, all the things that are going on in the figure. Now notice that I'm only going on the outline, only doing the outside of the drawing. Notice things like, so when we draw a skirt, it's a really good indication of like where the leg is. Sometimes the leg is right next to the hemline, and sometimes it's halfway in. And so you can start to use the drawing to help you understand the actual pose. That's always good. And for the person, I think in Italy, about the feet, notice what I've just done with the feet. I really don't overthink it, but like I said, if you do really want to perfect these feet, I think this line drawing might really, really help you. Also, when you're trying to draw something specific, or if you're stuck with something, look what other people do. Maybe I'm not the best example to go and look at, but you know, the Egon Schiele's hands. I love. Consider how he gets those details down. Or look at other fashion illustrators, other artists, and start to think about that. Now, hopefully you notice that I really took my time around here. And I found information. I got details from the creases here. And I really tried to understand and engage with the subject very differently from the warm-ups that we've done. This is how you should do it. And at that kind of speed, this is how you shouldn't do it. Oh yeah, there's the arm, la, yeah, done, bam, bam. Okay, now I like the result here, but I have no connection with what was happening in the image, okay? And the idea of the continual line is to gain a connection. Now, don't worry if you're still carrying on with this outline. Don't worry if you're still completing it, that's fine. But I'm going to move on to the next one, because we're gonna have two images on this page. So we're gonna do exactly the same exercise, and we're going to make sure that they overlap. And again, if anybody has a camera with them, feel free to take a photograph of this, because it's something you can work into later on. I'm taking a different color pen, and it's also a different thickness as well. It's more like a paintbrush. It's got a paintbrush type tip. Again, you don't have to have a different color, but I quite like to. Here's the other image that I'm gonna do. You'll recognize that from earlier. And I'm gonna repeat exactly the, oh, I don't like this pen, that's fine. I'm gonna repeat exactly the same exercise. And again, it's just for the outside. Now, I'm literally obsessed with the continual line. It's how I get started, but also it helps get rid of some of our bad habits. Sometimes a bad habit can be that we're really sketchy on the page, or that maybe we draw the same line 10 times before we feel happy. And all of those can be a style, but at the start, sometimes they can feel a bit like you're scared. So this kind of drawing helps you be really confident on the page. That's what I think anyway. Obviously, you know, we all have our different thoughts, but for me, that's why it works.
Helen, we've had a few comments come through and a question as well. So we have Isha, who's joining us all the way from India, who's really...
Oh, wow. Okay, so look, I've seen a massive big foot here, by the way, because I really loved this foot. Exaggeration is fun. Anyway, sorry, Jen, sorry.
Okay, big hello from Emmy as well, who says that she's really enjoying this. And it's we have a comment from an anonymous attendee who says that they love the mixed textures. Yeah. And we've also got a question as well, Helen, from Callie, who'd like to know, do you have any advice for an aspiring freelance fashion illustrator?
I think I might know Callie. I'm not sure if it is Callie, or I think. Hi, Callie. Callie, I would be getting a portfolio together by like maybe... drawing from fashion images and getting a portfolio together and starting to send it to magazines. Like, that's how I started to get going. Once I graduated, I actually contacted a fashion organization that were putting on fashion shows, and I asked if I could be their in-house illustrator. And luckily they said yes, actually. I think I would have shown them some previous examples of drawings. And then once I did those drawings, I contacted magazines and asked them if they wanted to publish them. And, you know, I asked about 20 and eventually one said yes. So it's a numbers game, really. It's keep on going and think about all the different avenues that you can be an illustrator. You know, so I'm checking the time. Oh, 5 minutes. You've got 5 minutes. We've got 5 minutes.
What? Yeah, I'll give you 10 minutes today, Helen.
Think about, so I'm like, oh, I do fashion, but then I started to do accessories, or I started to draw people in cafes, so I started to get more of a repertoire. You like, I just drew a wedding at the weekend, which was quite scary, but you like, maybe you contact parties, you like, not fashion parties, but events, festivals, and say, can I be your illustrator? You like, can I illustrate the event live? Or even don't ask them, buy a ticket to the festival and do that, so that you've always got lots of different versions of your style and just show what else you can do. I hope that makes sense. That makes sense. It's a hustle. It's a hustle, basically, is all I can tell you, which doesn't sound very positive, but it's just, you don't give up. That's how you get into it, essentially. So guys, just really quickly, I'll try not to rush too much, but you should be left with a page like this. I'm gonna hold it up as well. So I've got these two figures on and they're overlapping. That's what's really important, that they interact with each other. And now what I love about this is it's a blank canvas. And you can do this over and over again. Like, you can pick lots and lots of different models and you can start to create your own fashion illustration, but also fashion design. So have a look at this page, like, what's interesting to you on your image. For me, I love this. So this is the first image, but it's actually come through into the second image. So I'm definitely going to focus on that. And if I'm going to start to think about a design, this is going to be, it's a whole new look that I'm giving here. So that's very exciting when things like that happen. Another thing that we're going to do is to look at some of the patterns that were in the pack. Again, if you haven't got the pack, I'll keep what I'm drawing to one side, but it also means, like, maybe you're going to have to be creative and look around your house. Maybe you've got some great curtains and you're going to draw those. Now, to begin with, how I like to start, I sometimes just, when I can find a shape, so here's just a nice, interesting little shape. I sometimes just highlight those, especially if it's been created by an overlap. And I'd encourage you to use, oh, this is a nice one. I'd encourage you to use lots and lots of colors, lots of different material. And, you know, the chances are you might have to finish this in your own time. My apologies. I'll get this one done, but you might want to take a bit more time. What I often do after I've started to highlight some of the new shapes that I've created is that I then go in and put a face in there and I just scribble down a bit of color, okay? Don't do too dark because you want to put your face on there. This might not be my pencil of choice, but I can't quite find a better one. So I'm going to use this and I'm making the face up in this instance, but you've got images that you can draw from. So feel free to do that. But notice how I do my face, bam, done. Like, I just do it in seconds and I do it with a continual line. And again, you know, these are things that I've learned over time. Like, you know, it's my style, but you can develop a style with practice. You know, it's just a matter, it really is a matter of practice. It's, you know, it's being committed. I put them some fun hair in. And now it's time to kind of explore. I'm gonna pick this pattern, mostly because it's gonna be a quick one to do. And I'm going to place it on the page. And it's up to you where you place it. I'm almost actually going to ignore, the outlines, because you're in charge. You're the boss here. And what we're trying to do, in one part, I'm trying to get a nice fashion illustration, but in another part, I'm trying to give myself some design ideas, some print placement options. So maybe these are prints that you've designed. Maybe you're not going to use mine, or maybe they're prints from clothes that you'd like to wear, and you're going to start to draw your own in there. And so it just allows us to have a figure to design onto. And I've done this overlapping, and you might be like, oh, I don't want to do the overlapping. That's fine. Like, do this exercise again, and then you have just two individual figures, and then you can just work into it. And Jen, how long have I got?
You've got about 5 minutes left.
Yeah, that's fine. I can do it quicker if you want. As I said, guys, I really liked this shape. And even just, you know, even forgetting about the figure, forgetting about, you know, the page, you know, even if we just ignore the face, I just kind of like this shape. Like, and later on, maybe I'm going to redraw this shape and see what else it can be. Like, maybe I'm going to do loads and loads of them and make a pattern from it. You know, it's, I think when you're, and I'm going to just do the rest of the outline a bit stronger. I think when you're trying to be creative, you know, you have a plan, you have a starting point, but then sometimes things change and you're like, oh, actually, this needs to be this or that. Let's put a bit of paint in there if I can find my, oh, where's my paint gone? That's weird. Can I find my paint? Oh, here we go. So I'm gonna block this because I love it. I'm gonna put some really heavy paint marks on, which are definitely kind of being inspired by some of these patterns. And hopefully, even if I don't get everything done, at least maybe we can have this front person finished. So then I'm putting, maybe I'm kind of responding to this pattern here, this one, and I'm putting in some of those dots. I feel like I should be finger painting as well to respond to that. That would be quite a fun option. I'm not going to, just because I know I'll get really messy. But I'm just going to draw in the second part of this, just so I can maybe try and get an element of it finished. Jen, you just tell me when you need to stop, when I need to stop, I mean, because I've got a finished version as well, guys, not of this exact thing, but of this exercise. But let's just try and get this really quick. I'm just adding stripes here. I know I haven't got stripes on my worksheet, but one, it's fast, but two, I quite like the idea of stripes. Let's just very, very quickly. I'm nearly done with the first one anyway, and I can show you an example of the finished one. Okay, so if we remember that this first figure, this figure here, let's get everything out of the way. If we remember, this first figure was inspired by this image here. So you could see that I've made something completely different now as a result of that. We've now got a new dress on there. We've got a new print idea. We've also got a new garment. Like this is like trousers and a big cape. Now I've just done this dress that you know, for anybody who's interested in fashion, when you start to look at this, and maybe I'll hold it up a little bit as well. I feel like the camera view's better in my screen. But you can start to think about what fabrics could these be? Like, how could I create this? The stripe underneath feels a little bit lighter than this heavy area on top. And then obviously I've got these like big trousers at the bottom. Obviously I haven't finished this one. Jen, I can carry on going or I can stop. It's up to you.
And carry on going, Helen. We'd love to finish piece.
Okay, so I'm doing it so fast, but what I love, what I've just done, that I love, again, you know, I'm being very complimentary of my own work. That's allowed. I love it when people are happy to say that their drawing is good. So again, this, you can see this really graphic outfit. This is what was inspired. This is what I used to draw this one. And you can see it's completely changed now. And I love here, you know, that was the bag. Now is this some like big pom-pom, and the way I've done this scribble, the way it's come out of the outline, now it feels like some big like fur coat or something. Like, I'm totally into it. Maybe I'm gonna add a little bit of color here, because one last thing to talk about is the idea of balance and the idea of, that's blended in too much. But I was looking for a nice contrast. This black is really strong against like this chaos around here. And then I think having this solid color at the bottom, I think that really helps like lift the drawing. I always think a solid color is very helpful. I'm gonna take a risk with this green. It might be just too weird against the red. I missed an opportunity of fun there. I could have given her some patterned types, but yeah, here essentially a very, you know, pretty rough. Do you know what? I like this, I'm happy to say. And what's really nice, look what I'm wearing and look what this drawing is. This is me, this is super my style. You might think like it's way too rushed for you or it's not enough detail. That's fine, make sure that you reflect yourself into your drawings. And I think it's really clear, you see my house, you can see me, that this is a reflection of me and your drawing should be a reflection of you, okay? So there's no right way. I'm obviously saying try this, but try it in your own way. And I think it's always good to hold your drawings back a little bit, because now I look at it, I'm like, oh, maybe I need a little bit of extra color here. And you can also fill the background. And just before I finish, I've got one, as I told you, I often work on a bigger scale. So I've got like a really finished one here, if you can see that. And again, to the friend in Italy with the hands, look at my weird hands. Own your weird hands, but the key is to do them, to get drawing. Oh, I've got so much more I'd love to tell you all, but I think I have to stop, right? I have to stop. But hopefully you can see this as something that just allows you to explore patterns and shapes, but also can allow you to design onto. And don't forget, when you have that empty silhouette, you can also just lay objects on there as well. And that can start to tell you ideas about, if you look on my Instagram, there's things like that, not trying to get followers, but just you can see options. Well, I'm done, thanks Jen, sorry.
Thank you so much. You've provided so much inspiration today and lots of laughs along the way. I've honestly never smiled so much during a workshop. Thank you. We've had a comment from an anonymous attendee who says that this is making them feel very nostalgic for their art foundation days, and yay. I relate to that as well.
Oh, that's great. That's the thing, like, and I wanted to say this at the start, like some of these things you might think like, oh, they're for kids, like this is, they're just doing this because she's doing this because they think I'm a beginner. But I teach this to degree level, you know, I also teach it to 5-year-olds, but I teach it to a degree. It's like, I think that art, it should feel like free and it should feel playful and yeah, you should feel good after it, shouldn't you? So I'm glad, because I think foundation is when you are at your freest, isn't it? So Yay, whoever said that, thank you.
Absolutely, and thank you so much, Helen, once again, on behalf of the whole Hospital Rooms team. It's been such an exciting and energetic workshop today. Thanks to everyone that sent through a question and let us know where you've been joining us from. It's always lovely to have you all with us live. It's now time to launch our end of workshop poll. If you could indicate on the screen how you found the workshop today, this will help us to improve the digital art school as we continue to grow and develop our new terms, bringing you a whole host of new workshops. That should be appearing on your screens now. Just going to pop that up. You can please let us know how you found the workshop today. Fantastic. Thanks for submitting your responses, everyone. Really appreciate the time that you're taking to do that. Fantastic. I'll just give that a few more seconds. Richard, if you can please prepare our slideshow to bring back, that would be great. Thanks for submitting your responses, everyone. Fantastic. So hopefully you can all see that back on the screen. So if you're still here with us, I would like to share the story of Hospital Rooms and how the workshop today has come about. So we are a London-based arts and mental health charity, and we transform inpatient NHS mental health units with extraordinary art. We began the digital art school in response to COVID-19 lockdowns when our in-person work in mental health units was put on hold. It's been hugely important for us to build a creative community where we can join together and feel part of something special. And we're now a Webby award-winning programme. You can find the library of our past projects and all of the previous Digital Art School workshops on our YouTube channel, where you'll find a variety of original and imaginative workshops with world-class artists, from big cat drawing to fantastical landscapes, storytelling, and so many more in between. Please do have a look and subscribe to our channel. We also have a Digital Art School newsletter, which keeps you informed of upcoming workshops, the materials you'll need for them, along with any relevant downloads and links to last week's video if you missed it or you would like a recap. You can sign up for that at hospital-rooms.com. We absolutely love when you share your artworks with us by uploading to our online gallery, and we always share your work with our artists. You can do so anonymously, or you can let us know your name and where you are. If you've created some fashion illustrations today, either joining us live or watching back on demand, we'd absolutely love to see them. We'll be back next week with illustrator and designer Jasmine Sarah, who'll be leading through our very last workshop of this current term, typography design. Be sure to register for that for free on our website. Once again, from myself, on behalf of everyone at the team at Hospital Rooms, thank you all so much again for joining us today. Another huge thank you to the wonderful Helen Bullock for leading today's exciting workshop. And thank you to our friends at Anthropology for your support as well. We'll see you all again next week on Thursday at 2 p.m.